the makeup.
Don't worry, this can be edited out.
My eyebrows are done at least. Where's my coffee?
You know what I have in the car? Are the mugs. The House of Destiny mugs? I forgot to bring them.
But if they're not full, I don't want them. You can give me an empty mug?
Well, we can pretend it's for camera.
But I don't want it for the camera. I want a coffee.
We can go get someone to get you a coffee.
I'm just kidding.
Are you ready?
Shoot. What am I not ready for today?
Ready? Okay, ready? There's people watching. Are you ready? Back, come on.
Yes, I'm ready.
It takes me forever. I went on a mission to find you and I couldn't find you. Then I discover that you are inside a suit. Asking you shall receive, but she did ask for coffee, but you know.
Oh.
You did specify. I was gonna say you didn't specify.
Well, not in a mug.
Yeah, that's okay. You need to keep hydrated. Everyone that got in this seat has complained about the heat. But I keep telling them and reminding them that last year we were rained out, so this is a blessing.
That is true. So I think it's great that we had sun because we were all terrified about the rain.
I think that we're never satisfied human beings.
I think that's quite true.
But we had a good turnout.
We did.
Are you content?
Whatever state I am content. Whatever suit I am wearing, I have learned to be content.
Whatever shirt I am wearing. Like five different shirts today. One said pastor, one said security.
Mm-hmm.
She was inside the... Should we say it all out because there's kids around?
Yeah, they all found me getting like...
She was spiked today. She was braving the heat in that suit.
Yes.
We
counted all joy when we suffered for Christ.
You took one for the team.
Yeah.
It's.
I think it's great when we have the community around and whatever we can do to engage them for the Lord and bring them in is...
You guys can't see, but right behind the camera, there's a happy kid with a bike.
Yeah. That's
I'm
great.
Thinking this bike is way too big for the kid, but he has a smile on his face.
Uh-huh. Should we ask him if he can ride that?
Well.
Actually, I saw his sister earlier pushing him on the bike. He was sitting on the bike and his older sister with a big smile was pushing him. So either way, it works.
I mean, kids are leaving happy.
He will grow into
kids
it.
Kids have, everyone left with a goodie bag, with a backpack, the set for school with school supplies.
Mm-hmm.
Everyone left with something in their hands. And
you
I
know,
think,
even during the prayer, you get a little nervous that parents are going to be like, oh, I came for backpacks, I came for fun, but I didn't come for you to like spiritualize this over my children.
Yeah.
And even them, they were agreeing and shaking their heads that when we were saying they're going to be doctors, they're going to be, you know, the next generation of police officers. They were shaking their heads in agreement with what we were proclaiming because we have speak life. We're speaking life over this generation. And it's fantastic. The police officers that are here blocking off the streets.
They're doing a phenomenal job.
Phenomenal. And they even helped with the concessions. They've been like...
They, as one of them, maybe we're not supposed to say, but one of them took a little break and got a pastor truck in the...
Oh, really?
Tank. Yeah.
Yeah.
So, dunked Pastor Chuck in that tank, and it was awesome.
They asked me to get in the dunk tank. That was the only thing I didn't...
Really? You didn't want to get
in? No. Because who's going to want to throw a ball and get me in the
Listen,
dunk tank?
I suggested a great idea to one of our speakers earlier. Having it as a baptized thing. Now we just dunk people.
When you get baptized.
You want to get baptized in the name of the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit? Just,
but you got to make sure that your ministers are good aim.
Well...
Oh, you mean like just pushing
just
the button?
Just pushing the button. There's no resistance, you know.
Yeah.
I mean, sometimes when you go to like dip them, they
You know, my sister got two dunks out of the three balls. She
did.
She got
my
husband like twice. He was like, I can't believe she got me twice.
He held up his end of the bargain. He was running his mouth in that dunk tank, and I was.
Now what will be the final deciding factor will be who raised the most money. Was it Pastor Chuck or was it Pastor Esty?
So, do you guys have that tallied up somewhere?
I don't think they've had time to tally it, but if there's been a lot going on and the person in charge has been kind of running everywhere, so we have a lot of people that have done a lot of work and they continue. They're going to rest Well, tomorrow everybody's going to be rejoicing when church is over and they can all go home and go to bed.
Yeah. So. I mean, it was a great weekend. And school starts soon. These kids are going to start soon. Staff starts already this week, and then they start the following week. So
yeah. Summer is
officially over. Yeah.
Oh, but you know what? I think this is a great way to end it, though.
This has been a great way to end it. I mean, kids, everyone seems happy. Everyone seems happy.
Mm-hmm. So lots of vitamin D today, and lots of sugar. You know, the kids that are crying are those that miss their nap because they've been having too much fun. So we're hoping that they go home and get a nap. And I mean, this has been great. It's been great to see all the people coming in. And the next step is the house is ready to, the offices are ready to become open.
Thank you for bringing that up because I wanted to ask about the property. Right now we're shooting, if you can notice the background, this is actually the property where the church, the mm-hmm. property will be built. And tell us a little bit about that. What's in the works?
So next week we have somebody coming from Virginia. It's the company that's doing the engineering, and they're going to bring in the builders and the contractors and everybody, and they're going to be setting, he's coming in to measure and tell us what we can and cannot do, if our plans, how the plans are going to work out, and he's going to come in and meet with us and talk with us and tell us, you know, how much more we need to raise and all that, give us the final numbers. So he's coming next weekend, so next Saturday, that's what we're doing.
And the inside too, I took a little deep, well, not detour, but I took a little behind the scene look earlier, and it's coming along.
So it's not completed, but it's to the point where we can set up and we can start using it as the outreach center offices. So
that's
we're
awesome.
Going to start working with some families of that have become victims of domestic violence. I'm working on somebody to donate the vision is for a playground to be on this property so the kids can have a place to play, but we're working with somebody to try to get a donation for a swing set and, you know, that has a slide and stuff just as a start.
Yeah.
So, yeah, things are coming along. It's been nice. It's been taking longer than we hoped.
Yeah.
But a lot of work, a lot of labor of love from a lot of different people that I greatly appreciate. And it's coming along. Gonna be great. And tonight we have the service outside that they're gonna do at 6:30 concert service. I think it's gonna be more of a concert. So
just really quick, if anyone was interested in donating to the building or getting involved somehow, how can they reach you or reach whomever if you have that information?
Yeah, so we do have a website, which we'll get to and you can post on the bottom.
Okay.
We do have a website, you can see it down there. you can also, if you want to make a donation, you can mail it to our P.O. Box. It's 523, P.O. Box 523 at Southbridge, Mass. 01550. Or you can get in touch with us at House of Destiny.
Can you reach us through social media?
Yep. Turnaround time for contacting you once you comment on social media is pretty quick. So you can get us through social media. It's always a great way. But yeah, we have some other ways that we'll make sure get posted as well on social media and different stuff.
Cool. Thank you for taking the time. I know you're busy. You're like running this whole thing and everyone's like, Pastor Becky. And I'm like, I need to talk to her. But thank you for taking the time to sit down and talk to me and get to talk to the viewers and so they can know a little bit about what's going on.
Thank you for being here and making sure everybody knows what we're doing.
Thank you.
Thank you. See, here we go. All right, bye.